In this video, I'm sharing my top 7 Google Drive time-saving tips, and I bet you there's a few productivity tips you didn't even know you could do. Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google productivity tips. Don't believe me, just watch. No, seriously, when we're done here today, check out my Google Tips and Tactics playlist. So are you ready for the best Google Drive tips for productivity? Then let's go. Tip number 1, search Drive from your address bar. That's right, you can search for and open files and documents without even opening up Google Drive first. From any tab in Chrome, simply type Drive and then press Tab and search for whatever it is that you want to open from your Drive. Then just hit Enter. And voila, you've opened a tab in Drive and you didn't even have to go to Drive first. Now, if you're a regular around these parts being my videos, you'll know this is actually a Google Chrome tip that works for other sites too. But don't worry, I've linked to that Google Chrome video in the description below. Now don't fret, if you try this tip and it doesn't work, you may have to enable it in your Chrome settings first. So here's how. From a Chrome tab, head to the 3-dot menu icon and select Settings. Then select Search Engine on the left. And from here, select Manage Search Engines. Under Default Search Engines, click Add. And here's where you'd add Google Drive as the search engine with Drive as the keyword. And then you're gonna copy and paste in this search string, which, by the way, I have linked for you below. So just click Add and you're all set. By the way, if you're new to Drive and you want to know how to use Google Drive, I have a whole video on just that that I have linked to in the description below. Plus, I've linked to a video featuring even more Google Drive time-saving tips. Tip number 2, use advanced search. This is really handy if you can't remember the full name of the file or document. From your Drive, head on up to the search bar and click the drop-down arrow to the right to bring up your advanced search. If you remember the type of file you're searching for, you can add that here to help narrow it down. And if you know who created it, that's gonna be even more helpful. So was it you or someone else that created it? Then under item, just type in whatever it is that you can remember, even just part of the title here. Then just hit enter. And voila, Google Drive does the search work for you. Tip number 3 is one of my all-time favorite Google Drive tips. And I've told y'all about this one before, but let's do it one more time for the cheap seats in the back. And that's to convert any image into text. That's right, as in extract text from any image or PDF file. Wowza. So here I've taken a screenshot of a really good cookie recipe, and I want to write out this recipe to save it and not just have an image of it. So though I can comment on this image, I can't actually grab the text to copy and paste it over into a doc. I don't want to waste time and rewrite out this entire recipe from scratch. I just want to use this text that I see in this picture. So I'm going to close out of the full screen preview here and right click on the image to select Open with Google Docs. So this opens a brand new Google Docs tab, and you're gonna have the image file at the top of the doc, but scroll down on that doc, and below that, oh, well, hello, would you look at that? All the text from the image is right here in a completely editable format. Yes, please. This time-saving trick will work with any image that has text because Google is using what's called optical character recognition, or OCR technology. And speaking of OCR technology, If you're liking these videos so far, please remember to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for even more Google goodness. Tip number 4, change your default apps. This one is a Google Drive mobile app tip. Okay, so from your Drive app on your phone, select the menu and then tap on Settings. And from here, go ahead and select Default Apps. Here is where you can change all of the default apps that open from links in Drive. There's browser options and mail options, there's map options, and even calendar options too. Tip number 5, enable offline sync. This one's gonna be really helpful if you have to edit something on the go, regardless of your internet connectivity. From your Drive, click the settings gear and click on settings. From here, you're gonna notice an offline option. Make sure this is toggled on, as this is what's gonna allow you to create, view, and edit your docs, sheets, and slides, and any other files while offline. So let's say you're traveling and you don't have access to Wi-Fi. This way you can continue to work on that document from the device that you've enabled offline sync for. And then everything will automatically sync as soon as you get back on Wi-Fi. Tip number 6, find and insert links without even leaving the file you're working in. Yeah, you can do that too. So let's say you're working on a file and you easily want to find and insert a hyperlink. Sure, you could open up another tab and you could search for the website and then copy and paste it back over into your file, but that would take way too long. Instead, simply highlight the word, right click, and select link. Now, there's a few things to pay attention to here in this little pop-up. First, Google will give you suggestions for sites based on what it is that you're trying to hyperlink. So if it's something that it recognizes, you'll have those pulled up here first. So if that happens to be what you want, all you have to do is select that and it'll automatically add that link for you. But you can also search for a site right here too by simply typing in what it is that you're looking for and then making the selection right from here. Voila. And we've come to the end of the line. Tip number 7, automatic substitutions. Now I know what you're thinking. What the heck does that mean? Well, that's what I'm here for, to tell you what it means. So if you're anything like me and you make the same errors while typing by constantly hitting the wrong keys over and over again, whoopsie, you'll want to enable Drive to set automatic substitutions, as in, whoops, I didn't mean that, I meant that. So from any file you're working on in Drive, head on up to the Tools menu, and from here, select Preferences. In your Preferences pop-up, there's a Substitutions tab. Go ahead and click on that, and right now at the top, we're gonna make sure our automatic substitutions is toggled on. But here's not only where you can add your own substitutions, but you can also see what already exists. This is kind of like hidden keyboard shortcuts within Drive. So here's your quick shortcut for the copyright symbol. There's arrows, fractions, the trademark symbol, and more. You can change any of these too, by the way, if you want. And you can toggle any on or off, and you can even delete them altogether. But let's stay focused for a second here, and we're gonna add one in ourselves. So for example, I often type don't wrong. So I'll put in what I sometimes type by mistake, and then over here I'm gonna tell Drive to replace it with the proper spelling. Once you're done, just select okay, and you're all set. Remember, if you want even more Google Drive tips for productivity, be sure to check out all the links below. And warning, there's a lot of Google Drive tips. So those are my top 7 Google Drive time-saving tips. Do you have any favorite productivity tips? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google Drive content. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.